فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. Verily all praise is for Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid and we ask for His forgiveness. And we seek refuge with Allah from the evils of ourselves and from the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, there is none who can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah misguides, there is none who can guide him. And I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah alone, having no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. May the peace and blessings be upon him, his progeny, his companions, and all those who follow in their footsteps until the day of judgment. Ibadullah, O slaves of Allah, ittaqullah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verily today, brothers and sisters in Islam, Eid al-Adha, the 10th day of Dhul-Hijjah, which is the last or the 12th month of the Hijri calendar, or Islamic calendar, is indeed a great day. It is as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Afdalul ayyam 'inda Allah yawm an-nahr." The greatest day in the sight of Allah. May Allah be blessed and exalted, is the day of sacrifice. It is also the greatest day of Hajj, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us in the hadith. The reason why it is described as being the greatest day of the year is that it combines so many acts of worship, so many acts of ibadah, which are not combined on any other day, such as the Eid Salah, the offering of the sacrifice, reciting the takbir, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Widespread remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the Hujjaj in Mecca and Makarrama, the pilgrims in Mecca, they offer the sacrifice, they perform the stoning of the pillars that represent the shaitan, shaving of the head for the men and taking apart the woman's hair, performing the tawaf, the circumambulation of Baytullah, the Kaaba, and the sa'i, the running between the sa'i, the Safa and Marwa. O Muslims, the animal sacrifice which we make on this great day, Eid al-Adha, reminds us of our dear Prophet alayhi salam, Khalilullah Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father of the prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Ibrahim the blessing of a son in his old age. The Quran speaks of this story in Surah Ibrahim, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhamdulillah alladhi wahaba li ala al-kibr Ismail wa Ishaq inna rabbi la sami'u ad-du'a. Praise be to Allah, Alhamdulillah, who has given me Ismail and Ishaq in my old age. Indeed, my Rabb, indeed, my cherisher and sustainer, hears all prayers. Sami'u ad-du'a. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Ibrahim was very happy by this news, as any one of you would when you are to become a parent. So then imagine the test that he would face when he left both baby Ibrahim, Abi Ismail, and his wife, and the mother,
of Isma'il in an empty desert where even a plant could not be seen. But this land, even though it was bare, barren desert, was the purest and most blessed place on earth, as it was near the Baytullah, the Kaaba, and the noble city of Mecca, as mentioned in Surah Ibrahim. So Ibrahim left his wife and his son in the care of Allah alone. See, brothers and sisters in Islam, this Prophet Ibrahim believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one most trusted, and that it is He alone that helps those who believe. Tawakkul ala Allah. When Ismail had grown up and reached an age of maturity, it was then that Ibrahim alayhi salam returned to his family. Ibrahim alayhi salam had returned an old man. He was now back together with his wife and his child in his homeland. Ibrahim alayhi salam was full of joy at the prospect of watching his son grow up and spending their lives together as a family. But now, this prophet, this great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was to face a whole test of a different kind, unique. Ibrahim alayhi salam saw in a dream, he had a vision, that he was slaughtering his own son. And from this dream, he understood that his Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala, that his Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala was directing him to sacrifice his own son Ismail. So what did he do? What did Prophet Ibrahim do? Did he lose his iman? Did he doubt? Did he fear? Did he delay in hope that it might change? No, he did not. Kalla. Instead, with all calmness, with all tranquility, he spoke to his dear son, the young boy. And this is how the Quran tells the story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ فلما بلغ معه السعي قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى فانظر ماذا ترى قال يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين فلما أسلم وتله للجبين وناديناه أي يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين وفديناه بذبح عظيم وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على إبراهيم كذلك نجزي المحسنين. الله أكبر. إبراهيم عليه السلام said, I am going to take refuge with my Rabb, with my cherisher and sustainer, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surely He will guide me. Oh Rabb, his dua, oh Rabb, grant me a righteous son. So we gave him the good news of a forbearing and patient son. When he reached the age to work with him, Ibrahim said to him, O my son, I have seen in a vision
that I should offer you as a sacrifice. That I should offer you as a sacrifice. Now tell me what your view is. فانظر ماذا ترى. Tell me what your opinion is. What do you have to say on this matter? That I should sacrifice you. The dear son Ismail عليه السلام replied, يا أبتي, O my father, افعل ما تؤمر, do as you are commanded, you will find me, inshallah, if Allah so wills, inshallah of the patient. And when they both submitted with full sim and salam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ibrahim already laid down his dear son in prostrate upon his forehead, ready for the sacrifice. We call out to him, O Ibrahim, stop. You have fulfilled your vision. Allahu Akbar. Thus do we reward the righteous. That was indeed a manifest test. It was a bala. It was a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ransom his son for a great sacrifice. We exchange it for a great sacrifice. And we left his good name among the later generations. Salamun ala Ibrahim. Salamun ala Ibrahim. Salutations to Ibrahim. Thus do we reward the righteous. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it was indeed a very hard test which required true iman. Like that of which, wallahu a'lam, none of us can ever achieve. Complete ta'ah. Sam'un wa ta'ah. Obedience. Sabr. Patience in the face of the trials. And expectation of a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so the relief came. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided a sacrifice in this place. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Thus does Allah reward the people who do good. Truly He is of the believers. Allah does not want the blood or the meat of anything. As He subhanahu wa ta'ala is rich, He is al-ghani, and is free of any need. Free of any need. He wants them to believe in Him alone, to be patient in times of difficulty, and to act according to the Sharia, according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Allah says in Surah Al-Hajj, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهُ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرَهَا لَكُمْ لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين. It is neither their meat nor their blood that reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not your sacrifice. It is your piety, it is your taqwa that reaches Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has thus made them subject to you, that you may glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you may say takbir to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For his guidance to you, and proclaim the good news to all who do right. The command to sacrifice this young boy came from the heavens, and so from that year on became known as the year of sacrifice. This great event is a reminder for our ummah, the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A reminder to the ummah of Ibrahim alayhi salam, whose tawheed we follow. Millat Ibrahim. O Muslims, on this day of Eid and the great Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would also slaughter an animal. It is reported that he slaughtered 2 sheep, and so the Muslims afterwards follow the sunnah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hajj, ولكل أمة جعلنا منسكا يذكر اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فإلهكم إله واحد فله أسلموا وبشر المخبتين الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم والصابرين على ما أصابهم والمقيم الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. And for every nation, for every ummah, we have appointed a ritual that they may mention the name of Allah over the beasts of cattle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them for food. And your God, your ilah, is one God. Is one ilah. Therefore, surrender unto Him. And give good tidings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the humble, whose hearts fear when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned. And the patient of whatever may befall them. And those who establish worship and who spend of that we have bestowed on them. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is an emphasized sunnah mu'akkada, for us to slaughter on this day and dislike for anyone who is able to do so, not to do so. One may be performed. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu said, the days of sacrifice are the day of sacrifice, Yawm al-Nahr, Eid al-Adha, and the 3 days after it, the Ayyam al-Tashriq. Slaughtering on any of these 4 days, either during the day or the night, is fine. But it is preferred, it is better if you slaughter during the day. And it is preferred to slaughter as soon as possible, as the sunnah. It is the sunnah also that straight after every fard salah, every obligatory salah, on these days of Eid, as well as the Eid prayer itself, to say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. It is also a sunnah to eat from what you have sacrificed, to give some as a gift to your family or your friends, and to give some in charity to the poor, as mentioned in Surah Al-Hajj. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا كما أمر وأشكره وهو الكفيل بالزيادة لمن شكر. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, عباد الله, O servants of Allah, Eid al-Adha is one of the festivals of Islam, a time of joy and celebration, a time which is prescribed for us to show happiness and delight in all ways that are halal, that are permitted in Islam, and to develop the meaning in the hearts of our children and families, for them to know that it is a time for us to celebrate and a time for us to remember, to thank and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a day of joy, a day of eating and drinking. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that fasting on these days of Eid is not allowed. It is also a sign for the people to know that we have room for these things in our deen. To our sisters in Islam, أخواتي في الدين, know my sisters, that the Muslimah, that the Muslim woman has indeed a great role in the spread of the deen, for she is the foundation on which the children of the future the next generation rests upon. She plays an active role in society and carries the responsibilities of spreading the message of da'wah through her wisdom, her confidence, her certainty, and her good conduct and behavior. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam specifically addressed the Muslim woman in his reminder on the day of Eid, giving them advice and guiding them through his prophetic teachings. He instructed them to give charity in hope for the good that they will find in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So keep her duty to Allah in all your affairs, as Allah loves those who obey Him, those who are pious and do good deeds. O Muslims, keep your duty to Allah and do good, just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed good upon you. Follow the Quran and the Sunnah and you will be successful. Take care of your salah, as it is a pillar of the deen, of Islam. And if you lose this, then you yourself are in loss. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our good deeds and actions and make better of our condition. May He subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all. Ibadallah, inna khayra al-hadithi kitabullah, wa khayra al-hadi hadi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa sharra al-umuri muhdathatuha, wa kulla muhdathatin bid'ah, وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ألا وصلوا على من أمركم ربكم بالصلاة عليه، فقال تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي.